Well, he has been our fabulous guest panellist all day and he's just terrific. And here on the panel, we're just a little bit worried what world-famous psychic medium John Edward might reveal about us. You've been getting vibes from Joe all morning, actually, John, haven't you?
I might be. I might have been. Positive.
Positive. Oh, thank God.
Positive vibes, yes.
That's the first time anyone said that.
What about from Jess and Ita? Anything coming from them?
Well, I pick up on energy, and when I was standing backstage with Jess, we were just talking backstage about when she was in New York, and then I said to her, I said, did you dance, or are you a dancer? Because she feels like a dancer to me.
Oh. So we is talked. That true? Were you a dancer?
A ballet dancer. Ballet dancer. When wow. I was younger. Yes. Mm. And did you pick up on Joe having a baby, another baby?
What?
Here's the deal. I don't talk about stuff that I did it off air. So if he wants to talk about it, he can say whatever he wants.
Yeah. No, I'm happy to try, honey. Light up those candles. That is coming home early.
We have, of course... Oh, wow. We have, of course, got an audience full of your absolutely biggest fans. So we thought we'd let you loose.
I always say full disclosure, like, I don't know anything about anybody that's here. I've never met any of you guys except that's for the true. Young lady in the glasses we tweeted earlier, correct? That's right?
Yeah.
So thank you for your tweet. But I always say that whenever I'm going to... You do a reading and I open up anybody who's in earshot of me, including studio and staff members and stuff, I can wind up connecting with them, which is one of the reasons why I wound up talking to Joe in between commercials, because I was afraid it might happen and I wasn't sure if he would be responsible or not. So if I come to you, just say yes or no. If there's something, does anybody have a question that I could start off with, or anyone would want to ask a question, I could start like that direction, throw your hands up, we'll get a mic to you. Should I stand?
Okay, yeah, please, just run the show.
Lady in the leopard print at the very back.
Oh, sorry.
John, do you ever connect with animals?
I do actually connect with energies of animals who have crossed, and they're part of our, you know, our fur family, and people are shocked to realize that they can come through and that they do come through, and then people wonder, like, how is that possible? And I say, well, if you have a relationship with a pet, you already know how to communicate with them while they're here, so it's that same type of energetic communication that takes place on the other side.
Okay. So. Can we also go to the lady now in the the orange top in the front row?
I've lost two loved ones this year.
Okay.
And I would just like to know if you... would know if they're at peace with their passing?
Well, I'm going to say this, is that everybody wants to know that our loved ones and friends are okay on the other side. And I kind of say the philosophy that I carry is that when somebody crosses over, they're met by loved ones and friends who've already gone on, and they are okay in their kind of crossing over. We're not. So we have to kind of work on us being okay. We have to own the fact that we have to deal with our grief. We have to honor that as we move forward. I don't know if I'm with you or if I'm back over here, but I have a husband or brother energy. And I say husband or brother because I feel it as a male contemporary to the side. That to me is somebody who would be to the side that's passed. Is that for you? Yes? Okay, if it's for you, then I have to tell you that the month of March or the third of a month has to be tied into the family, either birthday or anniversary as well. Do you understand that? Yes? And did somebody have a tear in their colon? Or was there like a tear or like a perforated bowel or something? Can you explain that?
He had bowel cancer.
Okay.
Well, they operated on him and he had a perforated bowel.
Okay. And we've not met, correct? Okay. Now, where's the J name? They're telling me to say J like John, J like Joe. Is there somebody who's crossed over?
No, not that I can recall at this time.
That's okay. I just feel like when they give me names, it's their way of kind of tying me into who somebody is. It sounds not common to me. So when I get a not common feeling, I always think it's either a nickname or it's a last name. So when I say not common, Jasper to me would be a not common name. So I feel like I'm supposed to say Jasper, or something like that. So just remember this. And are there three kids for you? Yes? Okay, and out of the three, two are similar and one is different? Yes? And then two people have the same birthday, literally. There's two dates that are exactly the same. So I don't know if they're trying to tell me that, like, somebody, like, literally, I mean, different years. So I'm not talking about twins, but, like, two dates that are exactly the same. Is that for your family?
No, they're close, but they're not.
No, exactly. This is exactly the same.
Go pass over to the woman in the purple. Is something connecting with you?
My maiden name is Jiggins.
Okay.
And
with the J sound?
Yeah.
Okay. Two people have the same birthday?
Yeah, my brother who passed from bowel cancer.
Okay.
And myself.
Okay, so here's the thing. Wait, are you guys twins, though?
No.
Okay, because I know it's not twins. I just want to be clear. Whenever I'm doing a group, and it happens for the last 30 years, is that whenever I make a connection with one person, somebody else in the circle will kind of, like, jump in and be like, wait a minute, that's like me, too. And they'll give me one piece of information that the first person can't connect with, but then you'll be able to. And that's why we say, look at like how the stuff comes through. So your dad must be passed too then, because there's got to be a male energy that's the drinker that was there.
Somebody, sorry?
Somebody's known for their drinking.
I don't know.
No, is that back to you? I don't mean like casual consumption. I mean like they're known not only for their drinking, but they're known for drinking a specific type of beverage, not like any type of beverage. There's something that's along that lines. And then somebody had a child that had a brain tumor, but then it was fine? Yes, there's a brain surgery on a child, but it was fine. Is that back there? Is the child still here? Can we get the mic back to her?
Lady in the back, in the black.
So,
my son had a stroke about 16 months ago.
And they did a surgery? Okay, yeah. And now he's fine?
Yeah, it's getting better.
Yep. Okay, what I'm saying is he survived whatever this is.
Mm-hmm.
Is there some bad break that somebody had in the family, like a bone somebody had in their body as well? Like
his best friend was killed a few months later in a car accident.
Okay, and did they say that it was because there was like a break in the bone and the bone pierced something?
That's right, yeah.
Okay, and where's the R name in the family?
That's my son's. I got twins, and Ricky's my son.
Okay, and then you just knocked out a wall? Wait a minute, this is crazy. Somebody, I almost fell off today. Somebody knocked out their wall or somebody pushed the wall out, but not because they wanted to? Did somebody drive in a wall or?
That's their best friend was killed.
Drove through a wall?
In a rock face, yeah.
Okay, because I feel like I'm not supposed to be doing this and then I'm doing this. And then I'm gonna say it in the statement form. There is a moment here where somebody shaved their head, but they didn't mean to shave their head, but they had to shave their head.
My son, when he had the operation on, when the stroke.
No, that would be logical, because you would have to, that's not
maybe
it.
Maybe one of his friends.
No, I feel like it's almost like imagine somebody not wanting to go spend $110 on a haircut, and somebody decided to go do it for the other person, and they had to keep cutting, and
my son did do that.
And then it got to the point where it was like, oh, crap, we got to just buzz this right off.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to jump to this side, because I'm being pulled over here.
That's all right.
Okay, so but we're going to go to a break first.
All right, we will be back in just a moment as John continues to read our audience. You are watching Studio 10. Well, we do have a packed studio here today at Studio 10, and it's because world-famous psychic medium John Edward is here. He's a good friend of the show as well. He was doing a reading on our studio audience earlier before the break, and you were getting a bit of a feeling from this bank of audience members.
Then we had to go to commercial. So.
We did. So does anyone have a question from this side for John? Lady in the red jacket right up the back.
My husband has passed on.
Hold on 1 second for the mic.
Here we go.
My husband has passed on. I'm wondering if he has a message for my daughter, Narita.
One of the things I tell folks is that I can't dial direct. I wish I could. Seriously. Okay. And Jonna knows this from radio days. I would say, like, you know, I can't just kind of be a DJ and kind of take requests. But one of the things I was getting over here, and I don't know if this is going to be for you, and it's a little heavy for morning live television, and I'm sorry, but I always like to preface it. Okay, is that I feel like somebody passed from a suicide where their actions brought about how they got there. And I just feel like when I said I'm being pulled over here, when I was talking over there, I got pulled in this direction. So if they're, and I can actually do it from here. It's literally right in that section straight ahead. So if anybody over there has somebody who crossed over like that, that's kind of how they showed it to me.
No, we're seeing lots of
it's connected
names.
To Michael, if it helps. There's an M name like Mike that I'm supposed to bring up. So I don't know if the name is Michael or Mark, but there's an M, direct M connection to this. And I know that as I was standing here, right about here, I went like, I'm coming over there. So it's wherever there is, because that's where I was getting it. So.
The lady in the green. Do you have something to ask?
No, I had an aunt who.
Crossed herself over? Where's the M name like Michael in the family?
Moira. Her name
Say it again.
Moira.
That's her? Okay, is mom still living? Your mom? So she would know mom? Okay, I know that there's a mom connection that I'm supposed to bring up, but they want me to talk about somebody who either was adopted or somebody who, the concept of adoption for me isn't just legalized adoption. It's when a grandparent steps in and raises a grandchild. It's when an aunt steps in and raises a niece. Somebody stepped in and acted as a parent for somebody that's not their biological child in some way, and I see that as well.
Yeah.
Where's that for you?
My mum took over the care of my nieces and nephews. when my older sister passed away.
Okay, so the mother figure to the child passed, and your mom did that?
Yeah.
If this is for you, then the month of April or the 4th of a month will be tied to the family in some way. So either April is a birthday anniversary, or the 4th month has, or the 4th month April has a meaning, or the 4th of a month. I still think I'm with her, but thank you for saying that.
My daughter's the 4th of November.
Say it again?
My daughter is the 4th of November. Is
that and she's still here?
Yeah.
Then that's just my way of knowing that what I'm saying is for you. So somewhere connected to your family where the person kind of crossed themselves over, there's somebody who stepped in to act like a parent to a child that wasn't there in some way. And then they're also telling me that, and I don't know what this means. Sometimes they show me stuff that I just don't understand. Mm-hmm. I'm seeing the scene of The Sound of Music when the nuns take out something in the car so that the Germans can't get away. So I don't know if you have a crazy rogue nun in the family, or if there's...
You have a crazy... Really?
Oh, well, she's not a nun, but she was like one until my grandparents passed. Yeah.
No.
No?
No, it would be somebody that actually took something out of a car, or something was, like, removed from a vehicle or a car for what they're showing me. So think about the woman that came through, the aunt with the M, the person that crossed themselves over. There's something like that, and I know it's for you, that there's something where somebody stole something or took something out. And then I know that I didn't answer your question about your daughter. I apologize. I don't feel your husband. Doesn't mean that he's not around. Doesn't mean he's not okay. Doesn't mean any of that. It just as I opened up.
I just want to know about people who are empaths.
Okay.
You know, pick up other people's energies and you feel drained and you need to get out the room.
I pretty much live my life like that energetically. Yeah. I stay away from crowds, and even like before the show, like I kind of say to myself, because energy wise, I can, once I know I'm going to be doing readings,
yeah,
I'm going to open myself up. I could pick up on other people's energies and moods that are not mine and I don't want.
Yeah.
So if you know you're like that, or somebody's very, very empathetic, you have to be very, very careful about where you place yourself. And
very caring person.
Yeah, and you have to be very, very careful. There's something called psychic self-defense. It's where you kind of protect yourself energetically. Mm-hmm. You know, there are people right now that are like watching this going like, what? Yeah. He's crazy, whatever. But there are a lot of negative ninjas that are out there. So I think you have to protect yourself from where they're going to kind of jump out, whether it be, you know, regular life or social media.
That was a great question and a great answer. John will be crossing over again very shortly, but first we'll have to take a very quick break. Psychic medium John Edward is back in the country. He's a great friend of the show. He is a special guest panellist on Studio 10 today, and with some of his biggest fans in the audience, we're going to let them throw some questions at you, John. We might start with the lady in this bank of audience members, lady in the glasses.
So I just wanted to know, I've been to have a couple of readings. My mum's also been as well.
Okay.
They can always pick up on my brother and another person, but they can never find me. And they never can pick up on my energy. I'm really open to it, but is there a reason why I don't get anything?
You know, I don't know the answer to that, because it would be me speaking about why another person can't do what they do.
Yeah.
I think you have great energy. I think you have open energy. I don't think you're not allowing it. If you're not coming up as a kind of subject matter in, let's say, your mom's reading, it might be because things are good in your energy. It doesn't mean anything's wrong or anything's wrong with you not coming up.
Yeah.
Sometimes somebody else might need a little bit more attention or guidance or insights in some aspect. So I always tell folks, in that case, if you're not being read, maybe you don't need it as much as the person who is being read. It doesn't mean we don't want it as much.
Yeah.
But like, I don't need to be read. I don't need to get information. So if I go for a reading, or if somebody is generous to read me, a lot of times it winds up being for other people that I'm still connected to.
Yeah.
So I still wind up being the medium. It's just for somebody else in some capacity.
John, we have a lot of questions on this side. We might start with the lady in the patterned black and white top. What do you have to ask, John?
I was just wondering how you would explain the feelings that you get to someone who's a bit of a skeptic like me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, what's the difference between being skeptical and being cynical to you?
Well, I'm open to it. It's just that I haven't been proved otherwise, but it's an odd concept to me, so I don't understand it.
Okay, well, it's about energy, and I always tell people that I love the fact that people can come from a place of being skeptical, and I encourage it. I want people to be skeptical. What I'm kind of intolerant with is cynicism, when people don't explore things and say it's maybe. And I always say, like, if somebody's a non-believer, like a flat-out atheist, agnostic, I don't attack them for not believing. I just go, okay. And in my head, I know one day they'll see differently. Your case is different. You're asking a question that's explore. You want to explore. So the way I explain it is it's about energy. We're all about energy. So if we had a helicopter on the ground, you can count the blades. But if the helicopter took off, the blades would rotate so quickly, you would no longer be able to see it. They would be rotating, but we know they're there logically because it's what takes it off the ground. So if you think about your loved ones and friends vibrating at a higher speed outside of the physical body, rotating so quickly, they're there conscious-wise, but you can't see them, but yet you can still connect it. So it's like, where's Facebook? Where's Twitter? Where's the internet? Yeah. It's a place. We all know about it. People are constantly connected to it in some capacity. A medium connects you to the energy of the spirit world. And my goal is not just to talk to dead people. My goal, I mean, it used to be kind of what my role was, but my goal is to be a dialogue starter, to raise awareness, to talk about negative ninjas and to talk about things of that nature.
You've been picking up so much energy from that.
And by the way, you have great healthcare energy. So when we talk about, so I don't know what your field is or what you do, but healthcare energy to me is healthcare / teaching. So occupationally, if you did anything on that level, like that's where I would put you.
I'm a student, actually. I study business, but.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just think of giving of your...
These guys are teachers, though.
Nope, so. Not them.
No? Okay.
Not saying that they don't have good healthcare / energy or whatever, but when I talked about you, that's what I was getting. And then earlier, somebody came up to me during the break. You claimed Jasper when I said the name Jasper.
Yes.
And you said to me it was your dog.
That's right. He passed away 12 months ago.
And to you, that's your child.
Yes.
So to hear me say the name Jasper and then reference it after the other woman asked me about pets... Mm. That to me is a validation of that process. Mm-hmm. But there's two dogs that have passed, not just one?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, and was one of them like blind on one side or?
That was Jasper.
Jasper was blind on one side?
Right.
And did that dog come to you at the age of 3 years old or was he like 3 years old? Then something had to happen at the age of 3 with that dog or with a dog. Like, did somebody have an injury with the dog but survived at age 3?
Not that I recall.
Just remember that I'm saying that. I don't know how else to say it, but as I always like to kind of revalidate the information.
Right.
No, I'm seeing somebody at the age of 3 having an issue. Did somebody here have a pet that at the age of 3 had an issue? And symbolically, I just want everybody to understand how this works for me. I see pictures and thoughts and words and then have to interpret what stuff means. So what I'm seeing is my dog, the number 3, and a bad paw. So that's how I'm seeing it. And I'm interpreting it as at the age of 3, there was an issue with the dog, as if there was a problem with it. So if it's not for her, does it go back to anybody that's in the same section? Because my energy is being pushed there. Actually, if I say to you October 5th or 6th in this section, I'm seeing my mom's passing, which was October 5th. Does that date have any connection to anybody up here?
The lady in the white scarf right down the front.
It was the day I was diagnosed with my aneurysm, which preceded me having my stroke. It's my ex-husband's birthday, too.
October 5th?
6th.
October 5th or 6th, okay.
6th.
Then if I'm getting that information tied to her when I talked about her with Jasper, there has to be an issue with the dog that, like, at age 3, there was something about an injury with the dog, and then it survived. The dog might have passed now, but, like, when the dog's 3 years old, I feel like something happened. And then is there a Bernard in the family?
Yes, my brother.
Yeah, so that's my way of knowing I'm supposed to be with you. Is Bernard still here?
Yes, he's in London.
So, I'm sorry?
He's in London.
But he's still living?
Yep.
Okay. And you guys have different dads?
No.
Then are there two different relationships that you had with dad? Like, did dad have one kind of relationship with you and you had a different relationship with dad?
Not my dad, but...
I don't understand.
With myself, I've had different...
No. In my perspective,
no.
Like, did you have a better relationship with dad than Bernard did?
My dad's still alive, no.
That's okay. I don't want to kill him. I'm just asking. We'll let him live.
He's 84 today.
He's 84 today?
Yes.
No, I'm seeing stuff about your dad, but I see a difference in relationship when it comes to your brother and then the father. And then I don't know why, but they're telling me that somebody was on a donor list or that there's a story about organ donor or you had a conversation with somebody about organ donation.
That was
or...
probably me.
Okay. So not about you having it, but I just see the energy of that comes up. And then Carol is who, or Catherine?
No, not Catherine.
There's a C or K name like Carol or Karen or Catherine. I hear it. Like, it's very much like Hooked on Phonics. It's like you have this, like, you hear phonics, I hear the consonant sound. There's a C or K name connected to you, either living or past.
past there is, yeah.
What's the name?
Auntie Catherine.
Catherine, yeah. Okay.
It wasn't known as Catherine, but she was a Catherine.
So I always say if it sounds better when you say it, it's okay. Yeah. I just repeat it until it makes sense. All right? Thank you very, very much. Thank you.
We have to take a very quick break, but we'll have more of Don right after these short messages. Don't go anywhere, watch it Studio OK. Okay, he's been our special guest all morning and he has been winning over even hardened cynics. Don Edward, we're going to get you to another quick reading. The lady in the blue patterned... Oh, sorry, question. You have a question.
I don't have a question. I just want to say how awesome you are.
Aww.
That's it.
Thank you for that. And I think that was a question.
Lady
is there
the
Anna, is it?
Yeah. Mum passed on a number of years ago. Just wondering if she's okay.
Again, as I said earlier, I absolutely believe that they are okay, but I can't, I wish I could just dial directly, I can do that. But when people say, like, I'm going to use you as an example. When people say, I want to know if she's okay, what are you really asking? Do you think she's not okay?
I don't know, maybe in a spiritual level.
Well, I think the reality is, you know, and I say this all the time, it's the number one thing people want to know. They want to know that their loved ones and friends are okay. And I know from doing this for 30 years that they are okay. But we're not, and we have to honor our grief. And when we do that, we put ourselves more in kind of like a harmony and balance energetically.
We have time for one quick question before we have to take a break. The lady in the back row.
Hi, John. I don't know whether this is something that you actually deal with, but I'm just wondering what your thoughts are about people existing in different time dimensions.
Parallel
planes.
Parallel planes? Oh, parallel,
okay. Like more of each person in different planes.
Well, there's a great book written by Richard Bach. It's called One. And he's the gentleman who wrote Jonathan Livingston Seagull. So he talks about that in that book, about how people are living in different versions of themselves. And he flies a plane and he lands in different places and how you can meet alternative realities of yourself.
What are your thoughts?
My thoughts are that I think that we exist that way in our heads and that we should kind of play out our choices and options in that way. And I think that we should be concerned about the lifetime that we're in. Like, I believe in reincarnation too, but I don't really think we should dwell on it about who we once were. It shapes who we might be able to be who we are today, but we have to own who we are today, be who we are today, and acknowledge it. So think about the concepts, but own this lifetime, this plane.
It's been a fascinating morning. We've got to take a very quick break, but you are watching Studio 10. More right after these messages.